Hi, on my last video I showed you the new Line 6 Pod HD desktop unit, and I went through all of the amp models one by one in the default state. Now this time I'd like to show you the user interface of the Pod HD and really close up. And it's basically just like the Pod HD 500 units. So I'm going to show you some of the new amp parameters that are available and some of the new amp channels and amp models, and I'll see what kind of a good sound I can get when I really work on it and put some reverb and all the other effects that I'd like to put to make a good sound. I'll be using my Telecaster here. This is the Mexican-made Telecaster with the Babix full contact bridge, Seymour Duncan SHR1 hot rails in the bridge and neck, and in the middle this is a Seymour Duncan quarter pounder. And so this is a really good guitar for blues and things like that, and also for rock, because these SHR1 hot rails are humbuckers. I do have a coil tap though. I want to put them in the single coils. So let's dive in. Okay, this first patch I made is called Meditation, and here's how it sounds. Okay, so what's in this patch? Let's have a look. Okay, for the amp, I'm using the Gibtone 185. The very beginning of the chain, I have my wah because I have the floorboard connected to it. Then I've got boost compressor, which is on. Tube screamer is off. I've got a chorus. And then in the amp block, I've got a digital delay. Now, I found a trick that you can, by using a really fast digital delay, which is at 20 milliseconds, okay, feedback at 1, if you put the mix at about 75, it gives you a 3-dimensional sound, just as if you would be using 2 amps. So I like to use that little trick to get more of a spacious sound. And I put that in the amp block. And then I have a ping pong delay, reverb, and that's it. I'm using a ducking reverb. And so that's what I have for this patch. Now one more patch I'm gonna play for you. Okay, what I have here is a default setting for most of my patches. And at the very beginning of the chain I have a wah, then I have a boost compressor, then a tube screamer, then a chorus, then my amp, then a digital delay in the amp block, and then we have a digital stereo delay and a reverb at the very end. Now let's listen to this patch, see how it sounds. Now I want to show you these new amp parameters. You've got 4 amp screens now. On the second screen is where you have a couple of more parameters added. The sag. I have the sag set at 76. I'm going to turn it up. It acts as kind of like a compressor. I'm going to turn it all the way down. At the default setting is at 50, and I had it set about 70. Then you have a hum setting, which I would never use because I wouldn't want hum in my sound, but if you're trying to recreate a real amp, some of them do hum. And then you have a bias and a bias excursion setting that was added. Now here is the Tweed B-Man Bright channel with the same settings that I have on my Dr. Z Crunch patch, but I just changed the amp and I turned on the chorus, and this sounds rather nice. Let's change the amp again. Let's go to the tread plate model. I really like this model. I'm going to leave all of my other settings as they are. I really like the low end. Since they've adjusted these models, they don't sound flubby to me anymore. They're a lot tighter, and you can really hear the chunkiness. Now here is a new model. It's called Line 6 Electric. It's pretty noisy too, but it sounds good. Now let's do one more. This is my, I call it SRV Clean. And in this model, I use the Gibtone 185, which I really like that model. I don't know why. It just, I think it sounds really good. Now this particular patch can go from clean to slightly distorted. So let me play a few riffs on it for you, let you hear it. And by the way, as I start playing, I'll kick in the delay and then the modulation, and maybe the tube screamer to let you hear it. Okay, so there you have it. Now you should have a better idea of how this unit sounds. Now you can really go wild with effects and stuff, but you know, I always think that less is more. When you listen to great recordings of these guys, mostly you're not hearing their sound drowned in effects. You're just hearing the guitar, their hands, and the amplifier. So I think with these new amp models, and Line 6 is really taking a lot of time to do it right, and I think you're going to enjoy this unit if you decide to pick it up. So, happy editing, and thanks for watching.